I'm going to go to the next one. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the 2023 Monavay Presentation Bull. Before we start, I just want to go through a few housekeeping things for tonight. The toilets, if you need them, are over on the left-hand side here. The ladies' toilets are just off the hall, and the men's toilets, you go down the passage a little way. This is a non-smoking event, and also no alcohol tonight. I'd also ask that if you could please turn off your mobile phones rather than just onto silent, because we're having a live stream tonight, and so that they can use the internet, because it gets fairly bound up. So if you could please turn your mobile phones off, that would be wonderful. We're going to get started very, very shortly. So we'll be back to you in a couple of minutes for the official start. Okay, I believe we're ready for our start tonight now. So, actually, I forgot to introduce myself. So, I'm Dale Minnie, and I'll be your MC for tonight. And I think we're in for a wonderful evening tonight. First of all, we'll welcome our official party for the night. So, we have our Monavo principal, Mr. Jonathan Rowe, and Mrs. Rachel Rowe. Next, we have our special guest speaker for the night, Mr. Terry Molan. Our senior school coordinator, Ms. Sophia Veering. Our parish priest, Father Paddy Mugovan. And some people this wouldn't have been possible without, our wonderful dance instructors, Mr. Trevor and Mrs. Sarah Ellington, and their son Harley. Unfortunately, tonight, Monavay Vice Principal Fiona Mulhall and her husband Shannon are apologies for tonight. So without any further ado, we'll now introduce our 78 presentees for 2023. We have Lucille Ahrens, Hugh Ackerley, and Regan Belville. Lucille. Lucille comes from Dunkeld. Her parents are Daniel and Joe Ahrens. When Lucille leaves school, she would like to have a gap year and then pursue a career in business or law. Lucille would like to thank her parents and her brother for supporting her. Hugh. Hugh lives on Ackerley. Sorry about that. Hugh. Hugh lives on Ackerley Road and is a son of Lee and Renee. Hugh plans to become a heavy diesel mechanic in the mines after graduating from Monavay. Hugh would like to thank his parents and everyone who helped put tonight together. Regan. Regan lives at MacArthur. Her parents are Nikki and Richie Belville. Regan would like to take a gap year and travel the world after finishing at Monavay. Regan would like to thank her parents for always supporting her. Charlie Adams. Felicity Watson and William McAdam. Charlie. Charlie lives in Tarrington and is the son of Katie and Trent Adams. When Charlie graduates from Monavay, he's planning to work on the farm or become an architect. Charlie would like to thank his mum, dad and grandparents for helping him through school and showing him life's essentials. Felicity. Felicity comes from Hamilton. Her parents are Kiman and Toby Watson. After finishing school, Felicity would like to take a gap year, then study either teaching or nursing at university. Felicity would like to thank her mum and dad for supporting her and her brothers for taking care of her. William. Will comes from Hamilton and is the son of Karen and Andrew McAdam. After completing his schooling, Will's future plan is to complete a gap year in the Australian Defence Force, live somewhere diverse, and leave an impact when he's gone. Will would like to thank his family from Scotland and Tasmania for being here, and all those around him who help him achieve his best. Bailey Baker, Mimi Chun, Lucy Collins, and Maitha Bell. Bailey. Bailey resides in Hamilton and is a son of Penny and Tony. When Bailey finishes school, he would like to travel as much as he can and work at his dream job. Bailey would like to thank his mum, dad, and friends for helping him achieve his ambitions. Mimi. Mimi grew up in Melbourne. Her parents are Rebecca and Matthew. Mimi's ambition is to make a difference in people's lives by pursuing her dream in nursing or as a disability support worker. Mimi would like to thank her grandparents and Susan, Philip, and Evie. Lucy. Lucy comes from Robe. She is a daughter of Jane and Matthew Collins. When Lucy graduates from school, she would like to become a psychologist because she enjoys helping people. Lucy would also love to travel and to continue her love of photography. Lucy would like to thank her friends and family for always being there for her and travelling all this way to share this moment with her. Maitha. Maitha lives at the Wannan. His parents are Josh and Madeline Bell. When Maitha graduates, his ambition is to become a diesel mechanic. Maitha would like to thank his mum and dad, Paul Aaron and Helen Bell, for giving him lots of opportunities in life. Flynn Brough, Cammie Coomber, Hayley Cumming, and Noah Burton. Flynn. Flynn comes from Haywood. His parents are Peter and Kane Brough. When Flynn leaves school, he would like to move to Melbourne and pursue a career in sport. Flynn would like to thank his parents for putting in the effort to allow him to attend the presentation ball. Cammie. Cammie comes from Hamilton. Her parents are Belinda Gray and Levi Johnson. After finishing school, Cammie hopes to move to Queensland and become a beautician. Cammie would like to thank her mum and Tori for always being by her side, Levi for giving her a baby brother, Nan for making sure her dress was perfect, and Anna for being her personal driver. Hayley. Hayley's home is at Donald. Hayley is a daughter of Rebecca and Paul Cumming. After graduating from Monavay, Hayley would like to attend uni and see where life takes her. Hayley would like to thank her friends and family who have travelled all this way to share this moment with her. Noah. Noah lives in Portland. Noah is a son of Rebecca Mullen. When Noah finishes school, he would like to have a gap year and then go on to uni. Noah would like to thank his mum and brother Jack for helping him prepare for tonight and for getting him through school. Thomas Calvert, Ella Dawson, and Riley Casey. Thomas. Thomas comes from Hamilton. His parents are Jack and Michelle Calvert. When Thomas leaves school, he would like to become a full-time mini goat farmer. Thomas would like to thank his parents for all the good times he has with them. Ella. Ella's home is at Croxton East. Ella is the daughter of Sally Finch and Ben Dawson. After finishing school, Ella's ambition is to be a paleontologist. Ella would like to thank her mum for driving her everywhere and her dad for getting her ready for the presentation ball. Additionally, Adrian for being there and her family for being here tonight. Riley. Riley lives in Penshurst. He is the son of Sally and Brendan Casey. In the future, Riley would like to work in sports management. He would like to thank his mum and dad for attending tonight. Tom Clark, Gemma Dyson, Hayley Dodd, and Xavier Cox. Tom lives on a farm at Warriewa. Tom's parents are Darren and Lisa Clark. Tom's ambition is to gain an apprenticeship in building construction and to follow his clay target dream as far as it can go. Tom would like to thank his parents for all the opportunities they have given him and for supporting his clay target dream. Gemma comes from Hamilton. Gemma is a daughter of Stacey and Adrian. After leaving school, Gemma would like to work in aged care. Gemma would like to thank her mum, dad, family and friends for always being supportive. Hayley's home is at Coleraine. Her parents are Fionnuala Neeson and Edward Dodd. When Hayley leaves school, she would like to become a primary school teacher. Hayley would like to thank her supportive family and friends. Xavier comes from Portland. Xavier is the son of Sarah and Clinton. After graduating Monavay, Xavier hopes to become an electrician. Xavier would like to thank his mum, dad, two little sisters, and his grandparents for attending tonight. Erin Hannig, Reese Daffy, and Alyssa Airy. Erin's home is in Portland, and she is the daughter of Patsy and Rod Hannig. When Erin leaves school, she would like to have a gap year and travel the world. Erin would like to thank her family and her friends, especially Alyssa, for their support. Reese lives in Balmoral. He's the son of Greg and Ainsley Daffy. When Reese leaves school, he would like to continue studying at Longanong. Reese would like to thank his parents for driving him each week. Alyssa resides in Portland. Her parents are Linda and David. After graduating from Monavay, Alyssa would like to travel, then go to university and study teaching. Alyssa would like to thank her family and friends, especially Erin, for her support. Charlie Field, Mairead Elshaw-Betson, and Josh Grant. Charlie resides in Dunkeld. His parents are Melissa and Adrian Field. After completing his schooling, Charlie's ambition is to work and also to see how far he can go with his football. Charlie would like to thank his friends and family for supporting him in his personal and school life. Mairead comes from Casterton and is a daughter of Marianne and Darren. When Mairead graduates from Monavay, she would like to study a Bachelor of Science in one of the many universities available. Mairead would like to thank her family for always loving and supporting her. Josh's home is at Pigeon Ponds. He is the son of Craig and Jacinta Grant. When Josh leaves school, he would like to go travel up north on a cattle station, as well as being a shearer before coming back to the family farm. Josh would like to thank his friends and family for everything they do for him. Josh Hallam, Ruby Hayden Simpson, Rachel Hassett, and Liam Hendrick. Josh. Josh lives in Hamilton, and he's the son of Daniel and Michaela Hallam. When Josh has finished school, he would like to work hard and travel. Josh would like to thank his parents for coming tonight. Ruby. Ruby lives in Hamilton. Ruby is a daughter of Michelle Hayden. After graduation from Monavay, Ruby would like to become a musician. Ruby would like to thank her mother and brother for always supporting her, her close friends who are like a second family, and her father who made her the person she is today. Rachel. Rachel comes from Karamut. Rachel's parents are Andrew and Karen Hassett. After Rachel's schooling is completed, she would like to have a gap year and travel before continuing with veterinary studies at university. Rachel would like to thank her family and friends for supporting her. Liam. Liam's home is in Hamilton and his parents are Rochelle and Michael. After Liam graduates from Monavay, his ambition is to game and be a movie designer. Liam would like to thank his family and those who have helped him get to this moment. Luke Fidge, Shani Hutchison, Xanthi Hoof, and Sam Fidge. Luke. Luke lives at Heathmere. Luke's parents are Jenny and Gary Fidge. Luke's ambition is to become a bricklayer. Luke would like to thank his parents for helping him get to this moment. Shani. Shani lives in Haywood. Shani's parents are Karina and Simon. Shani's ambition is to become a psychologist after finishing school. Shani would like to thank her parents for always being so supportive. Xanthi. Xanthi resides in Dunkeld and is the daughter of Annette and Andrew Hoof. When Xanthi graduates from Monavay, she would like to have a gap year where she'll figure out what she would like to do. Xanthi would like to thank her mum for helping get everything organised for today. Sam. Sam comes from Heathmere. Interestingly, he's also the son of Jenny and Gary Fidge. When Sam leaves school, he would like to become an A-grade electrician and possibly open his own business. Sam would like to thank his parents for doing everything for him. John Martin, Poppy Mason, and Cooper Hine. John. John's home is in Hamilton. He is the son of Martin Devassi and Bonnie Joseph. After John finishes school, he would like to see where life takes him, travel a bit, and make the most of it. John would like to thank his parents for coming tonight and those who helped to make tonight happen. Poppy. Poppy lives at Nareen and is a daughter of Sally and Greg Mason. After finishing school, Poppy would like to become a police officer. Poppy would like to thank her family for coming along. Cooper. Cooper comes from Portland and is a son of Josie and Lee. After graduating from Monavay, Cooper plans to study a degree as a landscape architect. Cooper would like to thank his family and Marcus for the ride. Diesel Hill, Millie Kruger, Tessa Kelly, and Archie Hintam. Diesel. Diesel's home is in Hamilton. Diesel is a son of Jane Mithke and Jordan Hill. After Diesel completes his schooling, his ambition is to become a professional musician. Diesel would like to thank his mum and dad for supporting him and having his best interests at heart. Millie. Millie lives at Tarrington and is the daughter of Kim and Scott. When Millie finishes school, she would like to become a dietitian. Millie would like to thank her family and friends for supporting her through tonight. Tessa. Tessa comes from Hamilton and is the daughter of Matt and Bridget Kelly. Tessa's ambition upon leaving school is to travel around the world and volunteer in underdeveloped countries. Tessa would like to thank her sisters, Ruby, Mairead, and Millie, her parents and grandparents, for always being there for her. Archie. Archie resides in Hamilton. Archie's parents are Deb and Dave Hintem. After graduating from Monavay, Archie plans to become a builder. Archie would like to thank his parents for getting him through school so far. Jack Jennings, Grace Mawson, Madeline McShane, and Thomas Kent. Jack. Jack comes from Hamilton. His parents are Kate and Adam Jennings. After Jack leaves school, he would like to play footy at the highest level. Jack would like to thank his mum and dad for being great parents and for all the driving they do. Grace. Grace lives at Keewar and is the daughter of Kelly and Dave. When Grace has graduated from Monavay, she plans to take a gap year, working on a station in the Northern Territory, before pursuing a career in nursing. She would like to thank her parents and grandparents for giving her this opportunity. Madeline. Maddie comes from Dunkeld and is the daughter of Jackie and Richard McShane. After Maddie leaves school, she would like to travel the world. Maddie would like to thank her parents and family for getting to where she is now. Thomas. Tom's home is at Dunkeld and he is the son of Karen and Adam. When Tom has graduated from Monavay, he would like to attend university to study architecture. Tom would like to thank his family for taking care of him and driving him everywhere. Angus Kissel, Ellie Mead, and Jake Hardy. Angus. Angus comes from Wannon. Angus is a son of Carolyn and Brett Kissel. When Angus finishes school, he plans to work and travel around Australia. Angus would like to thank his parents for supporting him, always being there for him. Ellie. Ellie resides at Drumborg. Ellie is a daughter of Jack and Kylie Mead and Michelle Cope. After finishing school, Ellie would love to travel and find a career that she will enjoy. Ellie would like to thank Jack and Kylie, Michelle, Mark, and Therese. Jake. Jake lives in Hamilton. Jake is a son of Peter and Kylie Hardy. When he leaves school, Jake would like to travel around Australia, then work in agriculture. Jake would like to thank his parents, Peter and Kylie. Tom McDonnell, Ava Nicholson, Tanner Nadziri, and Hayden Millard. Tom. Tom resides at Eden Hope. His parents are Dale and Sarah McDonald. After completing his schooling, Tom's ambition is to find an apprenticeship in mechanics. Tom would like to thank his parents for giving him the opportunity to come to Monash. Ava. Ava's home is at Minamite. She is the daughter of Mark and Jodie Nicholson. When Ava finishes school, she plans on becoming a journalist. Ava would like to thank her family, especially her sister Erin, for being her bestie. Tanner. Tanner lives at MacArthur and is the daughter of Victor and Joyce Naziri. When Tanner graduates from Monash, she would like to pursue a career in sports science to further build on her passion for sports. Tanner would like to thank the close community of Monash for their supportive and friendly nature. Hayden. Hayden comes from Hamilton. Hayden is a son of Lynn and Wayne Millard. When Hayden leaves school, he wants to be a DJ. Hayden would like to thank his parents, friends, and family for being there. Brent Mullins, Hannah Payne, Emily Pierce, and Oliver Newman. Brent. Brent comes from the Dahlia River community in the Northern Territory. Brent is a son of Joel Mullins and Velma Saylor. After finishing school, Brent's ambition is to graduate from university as a teacher and work with Aboriginal kids. Brent would like to thank the Kissel family for making him feel part of their family while he's away from home. Hannah. Hannah lives at Sorrento. Hannah is the daughter of Alex Payne and Deborah Lee. After Hannah finishes school, she's looking forward to having a gap year to travel. Hannah would like to thank her sister for being her biggest supporter. Emily. Emily comes from Hamilton. Emily's parents are Kylie and Andrew Pierce. Emily's plan for the future is to study further and become a farmer. Emily would like to thank her mum and dad and her nan and pop for supporting her throughout her whole life. Oliver. Oliver's home is at Glen Thompson. Oliver's parents are Suzanne and Andrew. When Oliver has completed his schooling, he would like to work on farms across Australia. Oliver would like to thank his parents for their support and his nana and pa for coming tonight. Noah Nichols, Lexi Purcell, Sarah Phillips, and Lachlan Page. Noah. Noah comes from God's country, Tirindara. Noah is the son of Marcia and Richard Nichols. When Noah has finished school, he would like to become a builder or build a contracting business. Noah would like to thank his parents, extended family, and friends. Lexi. Lexi comes from Portland. Her parents are Cindy and Trent Purcell. When Lexi has graduated from Monash, she would like to travel the world and complete further study in the environmental field. Lexi would like to thank her family and friends for their support. Sarah. Sarah lives at Hamilton. Sarah is the daughter of Jay Boo and Rena Phillip. After finishing school, Sarah would like to become a pharmacist and travel around the world. Sarah would like to thank her family and friends who have supported her throughout her endeavours. Lachlan. Lachlan resides at Penshurst and is a son of Brent and Bronnie. After Lachlan has completed school, he would like to go contracting in some type of trade. Lachlan would like to thank his mum and dad for everything they have done for him. Xavier Payne, Stella Raymond and Dave Pereira. Xavier. Xavier comes from Portland. Xavier's parents are Matthew and Lorraine Payne. After Xavier graduates from school, he would like to spend his gap year in the Australian Armed Forces, and after that, he's just going to wait and see. Xavier would like to thank his parents for supporting him this far, and all his family, friends and acquaintances who have changed his life for the better. Stella. Stella lives at Hamilton. Her parents are Corinne and Shane. After Stella completes school, she would love to travel and hopes to go further with her swimming, potentially professional as a career. Stella would like to thank her family and friends for being here. Stella would also like to say happy birthday to Lily. Dave. Dave's home is Hamilton, and he is the son of Dinesh and Sumi. When Dave has graduated from Monavay, his ambition is to attend university, and after attaining a biomed degree, he would like to pursue a career as a cardiovascular surgeon. Dave would like to thank his family. Lockie Phillip, Anna Rennie, Ella Sevier, and Archie Porter. Lockie. Lockie resides at Glen Thompson, and his parents are Paul and Naomi. After Lockie graduates, he would like to work in the agricultural industry. Lockie would like to thank his friends and family for all the things they do for him. Anna. Anna originally came from Melbourne, but now lives in Dunkeld. Anna's parents are Peter and Erin Rennie. After graduating from Monavay, Anna would like to continue her studies at university and become a paramedic. Anna would like to thank her mum and dad for being there for her and guiding her. And she would like to thank her friends who make her feel happy. Ella. Ella lives in Hamilton and is the daughter of Georgie and Guy. After graduating from school, Ella plans on travelling Australia. Ella would like to thank her family and friends for supporting her. Archie. Archie's home is in Hamilton. Archie is the son of Renee and Bernie Porter. After completing his schooling, Archie's ambition is to see how far he can get in his footy. Archie would like to thank his parents and friends for helping him to achieve all he can with football. Kyle Rook, Amy Shelley, Sophie Taylor, and Josh Ryan. Kyle. Kyle comes from Hamilton. Kyle is the son of Dion and Nadine Rook. After he graduates from school, Kyle would like to pursue a career as a builder. Kyle would like to thank his parents for encouraging him to try his best. Amy. Amy lives in Hamilton. Her parents are Aisling and Huey. After Amy graduates from school, she plans on a gap year when she would like to spend time backpacking through Australia before studying a joint degree in nursing and midwifery. Amy would like to thank her mum and dad for all the time and money they've put into her. Sophie. Sophie's home is at Bioduck, and she is the daughter of Melinda and Philip Taylor. After Sophie finishes school, her ambition is to travel Australia, then undertake further study in agriculture. Sophie would like to thank her family and friends for constantly supporting her. Josh. Josh resides in Eden Hope. Josh's parents are Chris and Tracy Ryan. When Josh graduates from Monavay, Josh would like to become a builder. He would like to thank his mum and dad for doing everything for him. Carl Seitz, Caitlin Urquhart, Ruby Wardlaw, and Will Walter. Carl. Carl comes from Portland and is the son of Mike and Sandy. When Carl graduates from Monavé, he would like to become an electrician. Carl would like to thank his dad for being here tonight. Caitlin. Caitlin's home is Hamilton. Caitlin is a daughter of Amanda and Grantley Urquhart. Caitlin's ambition after graduating Monavé is to either have a gap year and travel or to continue her studies at uni. Caitlin would like to thank her mum, dad, brothers and other family members for helping her achieve her aspirations. Ruby. Ruby lives at Balmoral. Ruby's parents are Terry and Kate Wardlaw. When Ruby finishes school, she would love to become a paramedic or obtain an occupation where there is never a dull moment, but she will just see where life takes her. Ruby would like to thank her beautiful family for their unconditional love and support and for always making her laugh. Will. Will's home is in Hamilton. Will's parents are Lee Beatty and Rob Walter. After Will completes his schooling, he would like to travel around while working and continue to learn. Taylor Lewis and Chris Wormald. Taylor. Taylor resides in Hamilton. Taylor's parents are Christy and Damien Lewis. When Taylor graduates from Monavé, she would like to become an actor, a musician, or a psychologist. Taylor would like to thank her mum and dad, her little sister Charlie, as well as her nan and pa, Michelle and John, her best friend Lottie, for making her the person she is today. Chris. Chris's home is at Bacara. He is the son of Ted and Pauline Perkins. When Chris finishes school, he's looking forward to a career as a residential care worker for young people in out-of-home care. Chris would like to thank his parents and family for all the support they've given him through the years. Chris would also like to say a special thank you to his mum and the other helpers who worked so hard making the deb happen. He would also like to thank his family for coming here tonight and Grace for supporting him. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give our presentees a big round of applause. I now call on Father Paddy Mugovan to say a prayer for us.
Just a quiet moment to soak up the wonder and the beauty, the goodness of this night. So God, source of all life and goodness, in whose image we have been created, we give you thanks for these beautiful young people and for their families and for all those who have formed and shaped them, for their school community. We pray blessing upon them. We pray that the dreams that they've expressed will be fulfilled. We pray that they'll feel loved and supported in their journey into life. And we give you thanks for for the goodness of this night. Bless all the families who gather, all those who have come from afar, and grant them safe travel home. And we pray through Christ our Lord. Amen.
And now for the time we've all come here to see. We're going to have some dancing. And I can assure you through watching the practices, we're in for an absolute treat tonight. So our presentees tonight will be dancing the Carousel to Somewhere Only We Know by Lily Allen, the Evening Three-Step to Sway My Way by Amy Shark, the Cha-Cha to There's Nothing Holding Me Back by Shawn Mendes, and then an absolutely fabulous theatrical piece to Land of a Thousand Dances by Jess Malvoy. So if our dancers could take the floor, please.
Somewhere only we know. Things could really end up everything. So why don't we go somewhere on the rainbow? Somewhere on the rainbow.
Conversations that were empty when unexpectedly I met your eyes across the room. They pulled me into somewhere new, and I never knew a pull so infinitely strong.
Yeah.
Say you say don't come and go like you do. Sway my way, yeah, I need to know all about you. Ooh, sway my way. Ooh, sway my way. Ooh, sway my way. Ooh. And it felt right, talking the whole night and dance until the sun came up. I've never been so open, but I can't lie. No matter how I try, you're something that I can't contain, like capturing a flame. And I know you love to move, like catching fire in my hands. Say you say don't come and go like you do. Sway my way, yeah, I need to know all about you. Sway my way. Sway my way. Sway my way. Sway my way, yeah, I need to know all about you.
Thank you.
about her and she knows it. I wanna let it take control, 'cause every time that she gets closer, she pulls me in enough to keep me guessing. I should stop and start confessing, confessing, yeah. Oh, I've been shaking, I love it when you go crazy. You take all my inhibitions. Baby, there's nothing holding me back. You take me places that tear up my reputation, manipulate my decisions. Baby, there's nothing holding me back. There's nothing holding me back. There's nothing holding me back. She says that she's never afraid. Just picture everybody naked. She really doesn't like to wait. Not really into hesitation. Pulls me in enough to keep me guessing. Oh, maybe I should stop and start confessing. Confessing, yeah. Oh, I've been shaking, I love it when you go crazy. You take all my inhibitions. Baby, there's nothing holding me back. You take me places that tear up my reputation, manipulate my decisions. Baby, there's nothing holding me back. There's nothing holding me back. Last time I think we took it way too far. I know we'd be alright. I know we would be alright if you were by my side. When we stumbled in the dark, I know we'd be alright. I know we would be alright. 'Cause if we last time I think we took it way too far. I know we'd be alright. I know we would be alright if you were by my side. We stumbled in the dark, I know we'd be alright. We would be alright. Oh, I've been shaking, I love it when you go crazy. You take all my inhibitions. Baby, there's nothing holding me back. You take me places that tear up my reputation, manipulate my decisions. Baby, there's nothing holding me back. There's nothing holding me back. I feel so free when you're with me, baby. Baby, there's nothing holding me back.
Switch.
Hey, turn it over here, get it. Turn around now.
Switch.
Turn it over here, get it.
Switch.
Hit it. Switch. Hit it.
Switch.
One, two, three.
One.
feet up. Put your hands on your hips, yeah. And let your backbone sit. Do the one to say. Got my little girl loose, yeah.
How good was it to see these beautiful people having such a good time? I think they deserve another clap. That was great. It's now the time for our special guest to have a bit of a talk to us. So Terry Molan's been teaching here for 40 years, and he exemplifies the spirit of Monavay. He's a man who, every special occasion, he's there volunteering, he's out there parking cars, he's doing whatever he can to help our students have the best time they can and to just blossom. So I think it's very fitting that Terry's here speaking to us tonight.
Thanks very much, Mr. Minnie. Mr. and Mrs. Rowe, Father Paddy, Ladies and gentlemen, grandparents, parents, sisters and brothers, the amazing turnout here again tonight, and the most important people in the room, and that is these wonderful young people, these 80 or 90 presentees who have done such a marvellous job this evening. I'd like to commence by just saying what an honour it is to be your guest of honour at this most auspicious occasion, the 2023 presentation ball. I had to tell a few lies during the week, as I did admit to the kids on Thursday night. I was all teed up to be the MC a number of weeks ago, and Mr. Minnie was off the hook, and then I had to sort of grovel my way to Mrs. Veering's office and say, look, I've been offered a better gig. And well done, Mr. Minnie. Big hand for Mr. Minnie. It's a tough job up here. It's a tough job, Dale, and you're just actually smashing it, mate. Well done. So I got out of jail on that one there. Very apparent to me and anyone else here present tonight that this presentation ball continues to be one of the most important events in the lives of our students. It's looked forward to each year. It provides an important rite of passage for our young Year 11 students. Occasions such as tonight are a fantastic way of building community, restoring what perhaps COVID took away in 2020 and 2021. As I said, wonderful to see so many parents, grandparents, staff, brothers and sisters to be given a wonderful occasion to dress up, get the formal gear out, and come together and help celebrate this special occasion with this special group of students. In particular, I'd like to congratulate the Year 11 students. Without them here tonight, there'd be no show. Each and every one of you have been a credit or are a credit to your parents, your families, and the broader Monavay community. It was just amazing watching close up there the joy, the excitement you guys and girls were displaying as you, especially when you got that last number, you probably realised it was the last number. And I guess to a certain degree, you were letting your hair down, you were breaking the shackles off. And it was great to see so much enjoyment and joy on your faces. So well done for that. I read somewhere once that people only need three things in life to be happy. Everyone needs someone to love, everyone needs something to do, and everyone needs something to hope for. And certainly within the group, within the year level, there's a wonderful truckloads of love. And as we heard tonight from the ambitions, the hopes and dreams of these wonderful kids, builders, bricklayers, diesel mechanics, carpenters, doctors, scientists, the list goes on. I wish you well in your hopes and dreams, Year 11s, and may no one ever crush your enthusiasm in the pursuit of what you ultimately want. Tonight is a wonderful celebration, an evening to be full of pride and joy. I think that nights like tonight recognise your growing maturity, your increased sense of responsibility, and to show how proud you have made your families and your school. Tonight's ball has hopefully taught you not only ballroom dancing skills, and ladies and gentlemen, weren't they simply fantastic? They were amazing. How about another round of applause for that? You certainly lit up the dance floor. I was a bit worried there when you started jumping. I thought some of those girls have got enormously high heels. I hope they don't roll an ankle. But thankfully, you got through it okay. So obviously, it's apart from learning much valued ballroom dancing skills, throughout the last 6 weeks or so, you've learnt the meaning of commitment, teamwork, personal responsibility, and a social cohesion in a formal setting. It is so wonderful to witness firsthand your increased confidence and maturity as a year level over the past 6 weeks or so. I would just like to just say how amazed I am with the standard of personal presentation, the dresses, the suits, the shoes, the hair. It's amazingly, you all look stunning. Girls, fellas, you look so handsome. Well done to you all, and it was great to see actually all the boys had their shoes polished. I spent half my time walking around the school saying, have you ever heard of a nugget and brush? And they look at me quite blankly anyway. So well done to you all, out of your school uniforms and dressed to the nines. You all seem tonight stand a little bit taller, you hold your heads a bit higher, and there's a bit of a strut in the walk. Well done. All in all, you have presented yourselves as proud young people, young responsible adults that you are becoming, and for that you are to be sincerely congratulated, Year 11. Continue to enjoy your special evening and may it create memories that you will cherish and fondly recall for many years after you leave this great school. Year 11s, thank you once again for the privilege of having me as your guest of honour. I thoroughly enjoyed it, and I'm very grateful and humbled, and like you, I hope to have fond memories on this night for many years to come. And just one more thing, a bit of a special request there, but I have changed the blessing, Year 11, so have a listen to the last line a bit carefully. So we'll finish off with this. It's not the end of term yet, but we'll do it tonight. So a bit of a tradition at school is we always end each term with an Irish blessing. So just as this is specially for our Year 11 students, and it goes something like this. May the road rise up to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun warm shyly upon your faces, and may the rains fall gently upon your fields. And until we meet again, may the leprechauns dance over your bed and sweet dreams never end. Thank you.
Thank you, Terry. Inspirational as always. I'd now like Brent Mullins and Felicity Watson to come forward on behalf of the presentees to say a few words.
Hello everyone. I'd like to acknowledge the traditional custodians of this land, the Gundijamara people, both past, present and emerging.
Good evening, Mr. and Mrs. Rowe, Mr. Molan, Father Paddy, friends and family of the participants in tonight's presentation ball. On behalf of all the students here tonight, I would like to thank Monavay College and the Parents and Friends Association for making this opportunity available to us. Whilst the presentation ball has changed in format and style many times over the years, it's placed as a memorable event for Year 11 students at Monavay and remains as significant as ever. Preparing for this event has taught us many things, such as how to work together towards achieving a shared goal, how to present ourselves for a formal occasion, and the value of hard work. Most importantly, we have been able to experience the joy that comes from connecting with each other as a community. In contrast to all the factors which can separate us, this event has brought us closer together, renewing and building relationships. We have amazed ourselves with what we have been able to achieve. It has been hard work, but well worth the effort. I would like to thank Mr. Molan for his attendance tonight. He's recognised and celebrated your 40 years of service to the Monte Bay College community. Please take this gift of thanks from all of us here tonight. Thank you also to Mr. Minnie, our wonderful MC for tonight, whose impeccable performance has ensured the evening has gone smoothly. Please accept an expression of our gratitude.
It is important to acknowledge the hard work of the 2023 Presentation Board Committee, who have managed to turn a traditional sports stadium into a stunning place of enchantment. We are aware of the hours planning, decorating, and care that has happened in tonight's let up. And we thank all of you for giving your time to make this a memorable occasion. A presentation ball would be nothing without the dancing. We are very thankful for the expertise and energy of our instructors, the Ellingtons, and their son, Harley, who also has attended practices each week. It is fair to say that over the past few weeks, we have had our... fair share of mistakes. And missteps. But also a great moment of where we felt a huge sense of achievement. Throughout it all, you continued to tell us that we would be successful if we worked as a team and held each other to account. And you are right. Please accept this gift of thanks from the 11 students. Finally, thanks to the presentation board coordinator, Ms. Pauline Perkins. Although you have organized many of these events before, we appreciate that you spend hours and hours on each one, creating a unique and special experience for the participants. We love the way you focus on this event being inclusive and fun, and it is clear that you care very much for the student community here at Monte Bay. On behalf of all of us, I would like to thank you and would like you to come and accept this gift of appreciation. On that note, I would like to thank everyone for the role they have played in tonight's event, and I hope you all have a fantastic evening. Thank you, Mama.
Thank you, Felicity and Brent. You certainly represented your peers with distinction tonight. Thanks for your beautiful speeches. Well, I don't know. I think we enjoyed the dancing so much. What do you say we have an encore dance? Would we like one? Okay. I think we'll have our students dance the carousel again.
Tired. somewhere to begin. And if you have a minute, why don't we go talk about it somewhere only we know? 'Cause this could be the end of everything. So why don't we go somewhere only we know?
Well done, everybody. We're now up to a wonderful time of the evening where the students have an opportunity to dance with someone special to them. The dance will be the evening three-step. So the groups on my right are going to dance with a special person, and then the groups on my left will follow with the next dance, and then we'll have an opportunity for a third dance with all the groups together with someone special.
Just a small town girl, living in a lonely world. He took the midnight train going anywhere. Just a city boy, born and raised in South Detroit. He took the midnight train going anywhere. A singer in a smoky room, a smell of wine and cheap perfume. For a smile they can share the night. It goes on and on and on and on. my bone to sing the blues. While the movie never ends, it goes on and on and on and on. The strangers waiting, looking down the boulevard, their shadows searching in the night. Street lights, people. Just to find emotion, having somewhere in the
So with our other dancers, do their special dance now. Thank you. And now for our final special dance, everyone will be on the dance floor with their special partner.
But I can't be one of them. secret side in plain sight. Where the streets are empty, that's where we run. Everyday people do everyday things, but I can't be one of them. I know you hear me now. We are a different kind. We can do anything. We could be heroes. We could be heroes. Me and you. We could be heroes. Anybody's got the power. They don't see it 'cause they don't understand. Spinning round and round for hours. You and me, we got the world in our hands. Everyday people do everyday things, but I can't be one of them. I know you hear me now. We are a different kind. We can do anything. We could be heroes. We could be heroes. Me and you. We could be heroes. We could be heroes. Me and you. We could be.
My goodness, what could possibly go wrong? Beautiful people, official guests, friends and family of the presentees, that concludes the official part of the evening. So please join us for some supper over in the East Stadium. There'll be some carbonated beverages, very fancy, water, tea and coffee, The music will continue throughout the evening. If you're upstairs, as you come down, please be careful. The lights are very hot, so don't touch the lights or otherwise you will burn yourself. We don't want that. So thanks all for coming and sharing this very special evening with us. We'll ask the presentees to perform a final dance at around about 11 o'clock. So we'll clear the dance floor and they'll set up and do one more dance at 11 o'clock. Otherwise, we wish you a safe journey home at the end of this evening. Thank you very much.
Yeah, you used to call me baby, but now you're calling me.